Outside the Breslin Center, East Lansing is a winter wonderland. But for Michigan State, this has been anything but a dream season. Corey Lucius played his last game of the year in Saturday's loss to Purdue, suspended for the season by Tom Izzo. Can the Spartans shake it off and get back in the Big Ten race? A huge game against arch rival Michigan. Now. Thursday Night Showcase presented by T. Rowe Price, and welcome to the Breslin Center. It's the in-state rivalry game here in Michigan as the Wolverines meet the Spartans. And for Michigan State, they have Michigan, Indiana, and Iowa in their next three. All three games have to be considered must-wins. If a team that began the year thinking Final Four even has a chance to get back in the Big Ten race, for Michigan, they'd just love to get a win, one win, as the Wolverines have dropped six in a row since opening up the conference schedule with their lone Big Ten victory. Hi again, everyone. Bob Schusen alongside Stephen Bardo. Thanks for joining us tonight here in East Lansing. And the news to come out of Michigan State, not good this week for Tom Izzo's team. Corey Lucius suspended for the rest of the year for a violation of team rules. So now a team that's been teetering at the top and bottom of the roller coaster all year has another dip to deal with. How do they deal with it?
Well, I think you do it by committee. And you can see Keith Appling and Austin Thornton will get some extra minutes. And, you know, you're not going to replace his assist work with what he's been able to bring to the team, but they've got to rally around this loss and somehow try to get back into this Big Ten Conference race.
That's a big game tonight against the Wolverines. We take a look at our star watch and a player that has certainly exceeded expectations for John Beilein, the sophomore Darius Morris.
Yeah, Darius Morris has been outstanding, really been aggressive on the offensive end, setting the table for his teammates, one of the assist leaders in the nation, and Delvon Rowe could be up for defensive player of the year in Big Ten, and his offense has improved in the last five games.
As we take a look at the starting lineups, first of all, for Michigan, alongside Morris in the backcourt, Tim Hardaway Jr. in double figures, five of his last six.
Yeah, Tim Hardaway Jr., you know, representing like his dad's name right there, doing a great job from the perimeter.
And in a year of inconsistency for Michigan State, Draymond Green has been tremendously consistent.
Well, Draymond Green leads the team in rebounds, assists, steals, blocks, and three-point percentage. So this guy is doing it all for the Spartans.
At least an hour, if not an hour and a half ago, that this student section was packed, every seat and every row filled for Michigan and Michigan State. Michigan State has lost back-to-back games to Purdue and Illinois. They've lost three out of their last five. They go to work early, though, and a foul called inside as Kalen Lucas makes his way to the free throw line. Tim Hardaway Jr. called for the game's first foul. And for Michigan, they've lost six in a row, seven of their last eight. They had quality wins earlier in the season at Clemson in the Big Ten ACC Challenge, and also a win that now over Penn State looks probably better than you ever expected that it would, but they've lost so many close games to top flight competition.
Well, the thing about this team, Bob, youth is what really jumps out at me with the Michigan Wolverines, because they've been in so many close games, Duke, Syracuse, to name a few, that they've played well, took Kansas to overtime, but they just haven't been able to get over the hump and close the deal. But don't be surprised if they rise up tonight against their in-state rivals.
John Beilein knew that his team would have to take a punch and absorb it early and make sure they kept this game within arm's reach.
Well, for a young club, this is an intimidating place to come in and try to steal a victory. Just ask Wisconsin, that was up 9 points with a little under 3 minutes left and ended up losing in overtime.
Shot clock under 10, getting loose underneath and having his shot blocked was Novak. Delvon Rowe came over to help. Summers the other way, pulls up, and Darrell Summers knocks it down.
This is a very good start for the Spartans. The senior backcourt, Lucas and Summers, haven't lived up to expectations, and just so much potential. But like seniors, they can turn on at any point.
Smotrich just about got the friendly bounce. And instead, it's Lucas in transition. Off to the freshman, Appling. Offensive foul.
Well, Michigan State doesn't like the call, but I like the aggressiveness. This is the Spartans that you're used to seeing, getting the ball off the rim and attacking the at the very end, at the other end, excuse me.
Zach Novak, the junior, took the charge. He was the first sophomore ever named as captain in the history of Michigan basketball. That was last year, so obviously he's the captain this year on a team with no seniors.
Yeah, you know, Zach Novak is having to play out of position, so he's doing a little bit of everything for his ball club.
And this time Novak has to give the foul to Delvon Rowe.
Michigan 5-0, Zach Novak, his first team second.
Well, the last time that Michigan beat Michigan State in either basketball or football, 1,181 days ago.
That's a heck of a stat right there.
Yeah, to everybody other than the folks watching us in Ann Arbor.
Michigan State showing up their rivals, Michigan, in terms of the high IQ quotient, coming up with that stat on their own. A lot of talk between these two schools about Michigan being superior. So Michigan State students getting a one up here early.
A takeaway by Lucas. Smotrich breaks it up underneath the basket, but it's out of bounds off of Evan Smotrich. Well, John Beilein in his fourth season. In 33 total years of coaching, he has over 600 wins, but below 500 at Michigan. And the reason he's below 500 is because this is a team that had a very disappointing year last year with Manny Harris and Deshaun Sims before they took off. Offensive rebound and a flip up and in underneath by Darrell Summers.
Well, you see Darrell Summers get inside and get that rebound and averages four a game, but he's so athletic. And he could get to the rim on both ends of the floor. The thing that Darius Morris likes to do is go right.
Score the basket plus the foul for Novak in the corner. Well, if you're going to get on the board, that's the way to do it. A chance for a four-point play for Zach Novak.
This is Michigan's M.O. right here. Leading the Big Ten in threes made per game at almost nine. And Novak caught it in rhythm. Got set and wasn't distracted.
Darrell Summers called for the foul. And if there is an element of Summers' game that Tom Izzo is not happy with, it is his extremely inconsistent defense. And they're going to allow the substitution. John Horford comes on replacing Jordan Morgan.
Replacing Morgan.
Yeah, when you going back to Darrell Summers, some think that his mind is clouded with visions of the NBA, but the NBA won't come calling if you don't handle your business on this level first.
Or if you make entry passes like that, Hardaway, coast to coast, can't get the finger roll to go.
Nice move by Hardaway Jr., but on the road, especially, you got to finish those small margin of error.
Offensive rebound by Summers, and he'll go to the free throw line. Foul called on Horford.
I like the aggressiveness of Summers and Lucas to begin the ball game. They're getting to the rim. Summers is getting on the offensive glass. And when you're struggling shooting the basketball like he has this season, the best way to get on track is to get an offensive rebound and stick back.
So Morgan comes back on for Horford. Derek Sherman for the first time comes on as the freshman Keith Appling sits down, as does Delvon Rowe.
See both teams going to the bench earlier. This game usually has a little bit more heightened emotion to it. In-state rivals, and throw out the conference records of both. They might like each other off the court, but on the court it's a whole different ball game. Watch Darius Morris. They'll give him the left hand. They try to sit on his right hand.
Novak with the shot clock down to 7. Trying to create some space inside to Morgan. And the jump hook goes for the redshirt freshman.
Boy, Zach Novak making plays. Threw that with his offhand, his right hand, to Morgan on the finish. So Zach Novak understanding the shot clock running down and creating something for his teammates.
And then a sloppy entry pass by Austin Thornton.
Well, watch Zach Novak. Looks up at the clock. Sees right there, goes hard with his offhand, draws 2 defenders, nice wraparound pass. Those are the type of plays a young team like Michigan looks to their veterans to pull off.
You get that bucket with 5 on the shot clock. The 4-point play by Novak as well, as Morris reverses it home. And what a great job by John Beilein's team to take the early punch on the road. They're about to get to the first TV timeout, and they've got the lead. And Thornton turns it over. Here comes Morris. He just about gave it right back. Draymond Green tried to throw it off of Smotrich. We will step aside. Michigan, just over 4 minutes gone by, and the Wolverines with a 1-point lead.
You're watching ESPN, the home court of Big Ten Hoops.
Welcome back to the Thursday Night Showcase presented by T. Rowe Price. Terrific atmosphere here at the Breslin Center. It's an atmosphere that sometimes can heavily impact the game early on, but Michigan with the lead, 4 minutes in.
They've taken advantage of 4 turnovers by Michigan State, and this young club has fought their way back behind some really nice play of Zach Novak and Darius Morris. Zach Novak recognizing the shot clock going down. This is with his offhand, ladies and gentlemen. Nice hook around pass to Morgan, who finishes in the paint. And then watch this nifty move by Darius Morris. Oop, now you see me, now you don't. Reverse, nice job by Michigan. Spoken by Coach was Schusen. Took their first punch and have responded nicely.
Well, John Beilein, talking to him before the game, he said, look, we're in a different position than most every other team in the Big Ten. We have 6 freshmen that will all play, and they'll play a lot. Most other teams have 1 freshman that plays 20 minutes, another that plays 10. As Hardaway, there's a freshman, and he's off the mark. But Michigan State's a great example. Keith Appling's a freshman. He'll play 20 minutes, and he is certainly an important player, but nothing like the youth of Michigan has to fight through every single night.
No, you're exactly right. And what's surprising, Bob, this is why Coach Izzo is losing hair in his brush in the morning. Because when you're playing with a young team, you've got them on your home floor, you can't have 4 turnovers in the first 5 minutes of the game and give this young ball club confidence. That's going to be the next evolution of Darius Morris's game, to be able to step back and hit that 3 when the defense sags. They're giving him that shot.
Has to try it now, and he connects with 4 on the shot clock. He saw the shot clock winding down and knew that was probably the best look his team could ask for.
Well, that's shooting 27% on the year, so with a guy that can score at over 15 a game and top 5 in the country in assists, you got to give up something.
From the corner, and the rebound pulled down by Morris. Hardaway for 3, in and out.
Well, Hardaway, he's getting some good looks. Nice setup that time by Morris.
Kalen Lucas with the acceleration.
Okay, we've been hearing that Kalen Lucas' speed and quickness are almost back. Coach Izzo said he's 95% back in that regard. So right there, showing you a change of direction and change of speed.
Of course, all of that coming back from the torn Achilles he had in the second round of the tournament last year. Smotrich for 3, partially blocked. And it falls into the hands of Sherman. Good job by Draymond Green to jump out and get a piece of the shot.
That's Draymond Green showing you just a little bit of what he does. touches every aspect of the game for the Spartans. And they got burned by that corner three by Novak earlier.
Lucas left alone. He's got another.
Boy, Michigan, they've got to do a better job of finding Kalen Lucas. This guy was a Big Ten Player of the Year 2 years ago. Had he not torn his Achilles last year, he might be in the NBA right now. Just a very capable ball player. You've got to know where he is at all times. He's no Jimmer Fredette, but you still got to know when he's in the building.
Foul called against Jordan Morgan. Moving while setting the screen. And here's a look at that jump for Kalen Lucas.
Look at this right here. Now you see me, now you don't. Puts it in fifth gear, and then he could have caught a cold at the top of the key. No one there to rotate. Kalen Lucas taking advantage.
Well, talking to Tom Izzo earlier on today, he said it's been a struggle for him to get back from the injury, and not just his quickness, but getting his whole game back. He hasn't shot the ball particularly well this season either, and everyone just kind of assumed he was back in uniform, therefore he was Kalen Lucas, and he would do what he's always done, but he also thinks that he has felt some pressure, Lucas has, to get it all back because he's a senior. He knows this is his last chance. And from the corner, another senior, Darrell Summers, connects from three.
That's how you break the zone of Michigan. You get the ball at the free throw line and you look opposite. Michigan State has done that twice already.
The answer, though, by Zach Novak.
And Zach Novak making it rain. Bringing tears out of the sky with that high arcing three.
Mike Keebler, number 20 in green and white on the floor now. His role will certainly increase with Corey Lucius being suspended for the rest of the year. Delvon Rowe spins into a double team. Good job to stay home by John Horford.
Horford showing you some strength for the young fella. Right on time on the double team and didn't back off. Michigan will take their time. Look for an open three or with such good floor spacing, maybe a dribble drive or a backdoor cut.
Hardaway bumped by Summers and a foul called on Darrell Summers, and we'll step aside. A 2-point lead for Michigan State, the in-state battle here in Michigan. We're back, the Thursday Night Showcase presented by T. Rowe Price here in East Lansing, and Stephen Bardo takes us inside the play.
Well, when you're going against the 1-3-1 of Michigan, you've got to get the ball inside and then look weak side. Watch here. Delvon Rowe right there. Freeze it. He'll get the ball in the paint and look opposite. And then here comes Mike Keebler. One bounce pass to the wing for Summers. An open look at a three. Textbook execution of breaking the zone against Michigan. Good job of Michigan State via the pass beating the 1-3-1 zone.
Now Darrell Summers, that field goal was his third. He already has 8 points, but just before we went to break, he picked up his second foul. So a little thin in the backcourt now without Corey Lucius, and Summers with two fouls will be on the bench when Michigan State comes back to the floor, and ESPN's your NBA destination. Tomorrow night, Paul Pierce and the Celtics head to Phoenix to take on Steve Nash and the Suns, NBA Friday. On ESPN at 10:30 Eastern. This game also available online at ESPN3.com and on your phone. Go to ESPN3.com for more information. Nothing says college basketball in mid-January like the Teletubbies.
Well, see, I know you know that with five kids. See, I know that too with my two kids. And so we know all the swiper, no swiping and all that good stuff.
Sad but true.
Dora the Explorer getting a shout out on college basketball.
Yeah, you don't have a little kid television show reference that I'm going to be unaware of. Novak again from the corner. He's got another. He's in the top 10 all time in 3-point shooting for Michigan, and he's got three threes here in the first half.
See, that's why you like veterans on your ball club. They want to go on the road and leave their mark. Michigan needing a win badly in the Big Ten. You look for your upperclassmen to set the tone.
Lucas creates space. Hardaway Jr. with the rebound.
Stu Douglas wide open.
Novak tries another. Four threes here in the first half for Zach Novak.
Boy, Stu Douglas had the look, but he knows he's got the hot man Novak coming in on the trail. That's the easiest three in the game to shoot is when you're running up the floor. You catch it, get your feet set, and let it fly.
Lucas left alone again. That's a lot of space to give Kalen Lucas.
And it's almost like they're daring him to shoot, trying to keep him out of the bucket area, but you've got to get a hand up on Kalen Lucas. See Novak trying to urge Horford to give a flare screen to try to get him open.
And Horford goes back door. Oh, and Novak pops out. So much attention from Michigan State rolls his way. Horford found himself alone.
That's why the key on the weak side is to have floor spacing. John Horford did a good job of recognizing the defense and adjusting.
A takeaway by Morris. The hit ahead to Douglas. Blocked from behind. But Hardaway there to clean up on the offensive glass. Great hustle by Keebler to get the block.
Well, Tom Izzo not happy about to let his guys feel it here.
Michigan State there first.
So we'll step aside for 30 seconds and come right back to the Breslin Center. A 13-2 run by Michigan as the Wolverines on top of Michigan State. A surprise score here on the Thursday Night Showcase presented by T. Rowe Price, and 9 of those 13 scored by Zach Novak.
Well, Zach Novak, again, the upperclassman, trying to lead the way for this Wolverine team that needs a victory. Doing what he does best, leads his team in made threes and taking advantage of Michigan State scrambling defensively, not finding him early enough. You got to force Zach Novak to put it on the deck, because if he gets his feet set, open look at the three, you see what can happen.
Michigan State has beaten Michigan here in the Breslin Center the last 11 straight home meetings. They've also beaten Michigan 18 out of the last 21 meetings. Draymond Green on the move, turns it over.
Nice defensive adjustment by Michigan. They saw Draymond Green was going to roll off of the pick and roll. Ball went strong side to Lucas, and they adjusted. Again, notice the floor spacing of Michigan. Allows them either shoot the three or dribble drive, making the defense adjust.
Keebler left alone. He's got it.
Michigan State giving Michigan some of their own medicine with the good floor spacing. And for the young players watching, Draymond Green gave a simple head fake that drew the defense that allowed Keebler an open look in the corner. That's why fundamentals will never go out of style in basketball.
Novak, can he do it again? That time just a little too strong.
Delvon Rowe with a serious closeout.
Lucas with the left hand. Novak fights for the rebound, out of bounds, off of Novak as he was pressured by Draymond Green. Terrific pace to the in-state rivalry between Michigan and Michigan State. All right, John, thanks very much. The Thursday Night Showcase presented by T. Rowe Price here at Michigan State. The in-state battle between Michigan and Michigan State. Think this game doesn't mean something? This is Zach Novak going to the team huddle as we left for break a moment ago.
And you know what he's telling them? Get the ball. You have an opportunity to get a loose ball. Zach Novak knows on the road in the Big Ten, it's as tough as any place in the country to win. And so if you've got loose ball opportunities and you're trying to beat the team that's been your nemesis, your in-state rival for years, you've got to come up with those plays.
Summers thought about it from the corner. He's back in the game playing with two fouls. Ball rotation is Summers from the right wing. That's off the mark. Delvon Rowe couldn't keep it alive.
See, Mike Keebler is doing a really good job for Michigan State. If you've got a guy on the floor that will swing the basketball, it helps so much.
Right on the doorstep, Morgan couldn't finish after he was set up by Darius Morris. If you're going to beat Michigan State in their building, you have got to finish that play.
And so now we're seeing why Michigan can play all these teams very closely. but they can't close the deal.
Foul on the floor called against Jordan Morgan. And ESPN, the home court of College Hoops. Saturday afternoon, catch two games on ESPN. Action tips off at noon Eastern. A big one in the Big East, aren't they all, between Villanova and Georgetown. Then at 4 Eastern to the SEC, it's Kentucky looking to avenge a loss to Georgia. Both games available online at ESPN3.com and on your phone. Two fouls now on Jordan Morgan.
If you want to watch a surprise team, watch the Georgia Bulldogs against Kentucky. Georgia dropped a heartbreaking double overtime loss to Florida, but that team is on the rise.
Novak has it poked away from behind by Draymond Green.
If Michigan State can get the consistent effort that Draymond Green and Delvon Rowe exhibit on the floor, if the rest of their teammates can exhibit that type of hustle, that's the heaviest guy on the floor running full speed, coming back on the defensive end, getting a deflection, allowing his team to set up defensively.
Colton Christian came on for the first time as Novak sits down. So that's another freshman on the floor for John Beilein.
Stu Douglas, one of the prettiest jumpers in the Big Ten.
Foul called on Green. Trying to poke it away from Stu Douglas. That's Green's first. Fourth team foul on Michigan State. Five team fouls so far in the first half on Michigan.
Oh, John Beilein got a little timeout in there. Real quick timeout. His young Wolverines are looking very good here in the first half. To be honest, though, Bob, I'm not surprised. They've lost to UConn, Duke, Syracuse, and Texas in the non-conference schedule. Play Kansas to overtime loss at their place. I mean, they play against top-notch competition. It's a play here or there that keeps them from not winning these games.
Douglas resets it. Down to 10 on the shot clock. It's back with Darius Morris. Seven to shoot. Morris might have to force one up to the wing, and Christian, he's got it as the shot clock expires. A long two for Colton Christian.
Oh, Christian from Bellevue, Washington, making his impact felt early.
Summers attacks quickly at the other end, fouled by John Horford.
Once again, Michigan doing a good job of sucking the defense in as the shot clock runs down and looks opposite for the three. Colton Christian comes up big. What I said, UConn, Duke, Syracuse, Texas, that's Michigan State has played them and dropped those games. Michigan, though, took Kansas to overtime and lost at their place. They've played a pretty good schedule as well.
But also in the Big Ten, lost to Minnesota in their last game by five on Saturday, 69-65. Earlier on in the Big Ten schedule, lost at Ohio State by four. Right. They've been knocking on the door to get kind of that breakthrough win. But the bottom line is they look up at the Big Ten standings. They're 1-6. And this season probably wouldn't be that much of a disappointment for John Beilein's team if not put in context with the disappointment of last year. To go to the tournament 2 years ago, have Manny Harris and Deshaun Sims both in their last year, as it turns out, last season, with Harris leaving, and have a disappointing below 500 year and not make the tournament. That was really the season that I think brought John Beilein and the program under fire a bit.
I totally agree. And you got two guys who are pros, really, that just didn't get it done in their last season.
Giveaway and sloppy basketball by the Wolverines results in a Darius Morris foul. Well, the last time that Michigan was in the NCAAs a couple of years ago, but that was their first appearance in over a decade. They haven't won the Big Ten title since 86. In 1989, with Glenn Rice and Ramil Robinson, winning the national championship as my partner.
Yeah, you got to rub it
basically in. Basically gives me stink eye that no one except me can see. I'm sorry. I know it was your year in 1989, but that was the year they won the national championship.
No, it was their year because they won. You know, we had a good team, but they had an excellent team. So I'm just giving you a hard time because I can.
Seventh team foul on Michigan. So it is a 1-1 for Austin Thornton. And one of the best in the business, Ed Hightower, wanted to go over to the sideline just to make sure. It's a held ball after the one-and-one miss as Derek Nix reached over the top of Smotrich, tied him up. The possession arrow gives it back to Michigan.
You rarely see a jump ball called when one guy has his arms over the back and neck of another guy. Only in the Big Ten.
Douglas got it. A long two for Stu Douglas.
Told you Stu Douglas has a pretty jumper. And I've seen him get going. A couple years ago, he put on a show at UConn where they narrowly lost to the Huskies in Gamble.
Kalen Lucas gets tied up. Here comes Douglas the other way. Off the fingertips of Darius Morris in transition. And a great opportunity for Michigan. Lost out of bounds.
Let's take a look at Derek Nix going over the top of Evan Smotrich. Look at that. I mean, really? That's a little unusual, isn't it?
I think in so many words, that's what John Beilein said to the officials. Really?
Yeah, but you can't knock either player, though. They're going after the rock. That's what we expected to see tonight.
Thornton, wide open three, in and out. And the rebound to Zach Novak, who, by the way, is 10th in the Big Ten in rebounding at 6'4".
Showing you his heart, the junior out of Chesterton, Indiana, has to play a lot of undersized four for Michigan.
And by the way, I'm not buying 6'4". Saturday night, ESPN and ESPNU team up to give you a great Big 12 college basketball doubleheader. First at 7 Eastern on ESPN, Kansas and Kansas State. Then at 9 Eastern, it's number 13 at number 8. Texas hosts Missouri. ESPN, the home court of college hoops on ESPN and ESPNU coming up on Saturday.
Boy, Missouri and Texas? Are you kidding me? Contrasting styles, one team very physical and inside laden, and the other team just scratch and claw you to death.
Morris lost it, found it again, and scores. It's an 8-point lead for Michigan. 3.5 minutes to go in the first half.
It's a Michigan team that can score in bunches quickly.
Lucas tosses up a three. The long rebound run down by Thornton. Nice job by Novak to jump in the passing lane and knock it away from Green. And that brings us to our last TV timeout here in the first half. 3:21 to go in the opening 20 minutes. How about the Wolverines on the road here at the Breslin Center? All right, John, thanks very much. Bob Wischusen alongside Stephen Bardo here at the Breslin Center. A terrific first half so far between Michigan and Michigan State. And there are some bloodlines in the building.
Oh, definitely. Definitely players stunting like their daddies. What my son would say. Tito Horford and John Horford there. Joe Dumars, his son Jordan Dumars, who having some knee issues. And Tim Hardaway, crossover to break your ankles. Tim Hardaway Jr. does a little bit different.
Foul called on Smotrich in the corner. And with Michigan over the limit, that'll put Kalen Lucas at the free throw line. First on Smotrich. So far, Michigan shooting 55% here in the first half against a Michigan State team that averages allowing opponents only 41% from the field. They've been very efficient, and to be fair, they've had a couple of low percentage threes go down.
Yes,
I'm not sure if they can continue in the second half to live with some of the field goal attempts they've gotten in the first half.
No, you're right. They've gotten some as the shot clock's running down under duress. But you give them credit. But on the other side, Michigan State is only 1 of 6 from three. And most of those have been wide open looks. So not shooting with a whole lot of confidence.
Morris for three. There's another three-point field goal that goes down for the Wolverines. They are 6 of 11 from three here in the first half, and they've got a 10-point lead.
Well, again, you got a young team. They're coming on the road. They've got the governor in the building who's a Michigan grad. They're trying to represent young fellas from Ann Arbor.
Appling with the shot clock under 10, and the crowd getting a little antsy here at the Breslin Center. The freshman splits the defense, and the McDonald's All-American cuts it down to 8.
Well, he looked a little bit like Kalen Lucas that time. Appling just put his head down and was not going to be denied. But Michigan State's not really having a problem scoring the basketball. This is the end where they're having difficulty closing out on shooters.
Foul called, I believe, on Delvon Rowe trying to jump over the top of the screen. That's his first. And the fifth team foul on the Spartans.
But Delvon Rowe and Draymond Green both know when the pick is set by the bigs of Michigan. Smotrus is straight up and down compared to Rowe and Green. Doesn't have quite the size, and so they're trying to root him out of his position.
Smotrus for 3. And Delvon Rowe rebounds the brick. That's what my jump shots sound like when they got to get trapped between the heel and the backboard.
I'll see your jump shot. It's not that bad. I don't know if you had D on it, it might be.
Foul called against Michigan State. Moving screen away from the ball. And, oh, there's a team leader if there ever was one.
Oh, Mateen Cleese, man. You see the numbers speak for themselves. But you talk about a guy who was just like Izzo on the floor. Willed his teammates, got after him, and made the most out of his ability. Took himself and his team as far as he possibly could. Got the most out of his talent.
A foul called on Delvon Rowe, his second in as many trips.
So you got Delvon Rowe and Summers with 2 fouls. See if State can hold on here at the end of the half.
Hardaway can't hit from the corner with a minute to go in the first half. Kalen Lucas hits. And Michigan State also gets a 2-for-1 by Lucas knocking down that jumper with 50 seconds to go.
Did you see that tip pass by Draymond Green? As soon as the ball entered the post, they were going to double team. Draymond Green, recognizing, tips it back, doesn't even touch it with 2 hands. That's a high IQ basketball play by Draymond Green.
Evil got a hand on it. Hardaway was loose in the corner.
Look at this right here. He knows the double team is coming, tips it right back to Lucas, and gives him time to get his shot off. Draymond Green, even though he leads his team in 5 different categories, all his stuff is not in the scoring book.
We have a timeout on the floor and a chance. Speaking of a team, please, to take you back to the year 2000. His senior season in the national championship game in Indianapolis. And what an afternoon it was, and an evening it was for Charlie Bell, Mateen Cleaves, and Michigan State as they would win the national title for Tom Izzo. 1 of 6 Final Fours that Michigan State has gone to with Tom Izzo on the bench, but there's the year they won the Big Ten title and a national championship as well.
Well, and he had toughness in guys like Mateen Cleaves, and they really started a trend of getting tough kids from Michigan to not look at Ann Arbor necessarily, but to come to Michigan State and put their helmets on and come here and lay the wood on their opponents. And that's exactly what Michigan State has been known for. And this particular team had all the preseason lofty expectations, but they just don't bring the lunch pail mentality like the teams before them have here at Michigan State.
Antonio Smith sitting to the right of Mateen Cleaves. Taking in the in-state rivalry game, down to 12 on the shot clock for Michigan. Morris with 8 to shoot. Blocking foul called on Kalen Lucas. Tom Izzo can't believe it. That was a tough call for Antonio Petty to make right in front of that man, as he knew he'd get an earful. You be the judge.
Well, you got Kalen Lucas moving his feet. No hands involved. and we saw a jump ball with a guy draped over another guy's back. So, questionable call there. But, you know, Darius Morris reminds me of Dominique Wilkins. He's going right and won't go left, but they still can't stop it.
And Hardaway found the loose ball after the 1-1 miss by Morris. So down to 9 seconds to go in the first half. Michigan with a chance for the final look. Morris drives it. No good. 1 second to go. Home run ball on the way and over the backboard from Draymond Green. What a first half for Michigan, though. 6 of 12 from three-point land for the Wolverines. And at halftime, they've got the six-point lead.
Young fellas staking their claim and taking advantage of the Michigan State turnovers.
Six-point advantage for Michigan over Michigan State. Now we go back to our studios. John Saunders is standing by. It's the UPS Halftime Report. John? We had the Thursday night showcase presented by T. Rowe Price. Michigan and Michigan State set to battle it out for 20 more minutes. And on the strength of 6 of 12 from three-point land in the first half, Michigan with the six-point lead to start the second half. Bob Wischusen alongside Stephen Bardo. Thanks for joining us. How surprised were you by what we saw in the first half and how effective at the offensive end Michigan was?
Well, Michigan took advantage of 8 turnovers from Michigan State. And when you have a team that's reeling with the loss of Corey Lucius, you think they'd be a little bit more careful with the basketball, but they weren't. Michigan made them pay, and they shot it extremely well from the three-point line.
Now, keys for Michigan State in the second half to try and turn this thing around if they can.
They've got to score on the interior, take care of the basketball, and those open looks on the outside will be there. But they need to work outside in as opposed to, inside out as opposed to outside in.
Well, they try to go high-low on the first possession, and Delvon Rose pass to Draymond Green is knocked away. So a turnover on the opening possession of the second half for a Spartans team that has won 11 in a row at the Breslin Center against Michigan.
Well, not to take anything away from Northwestern, because they're a very capable ball club, but they took this Michigan State team on this floor into overtime.
Hardaway, step back jumper a little too strong. Smotrich, though, with the offensive rebound, keeps it alive.
So when you can see that a Northwestern Wildcat team can come in here and compete, that gives a team like Michigan even more hope and confidence that they can come in and do the same thing.
Draymond Green is hobbled a bit, holding his left knee. And he's late covering Morgan inside. Draymond Green got bumped. And you can see he's limping up the floor, laboring a bit, and he couldn't get back to guard Jordan Morgan.
You saw a really nice pass.
And now he wants to tap out. Green looked over at the Spartan bench and said, you know, let's get a timeout. I need to come out of the game.
Take a look. There's Green right there. Coming down awkwardly. And then just a slow rotation back. No help defensively. Morgan there for the foot. For the easy deuce.
An air ball from Darrell Summers. Smotrich is bumped by Delvon Rowe. Third foul on Delvon Rowe. So you've got Draymond Green on the bench. He's banged up. Delvon Rowe just picked up his third foul. Kalen Lucas might not quite be Kalen Lucas still. And this is a team without Corey Lucius, who was suspended for the rest of the season by Tom Izzo for conduct detrimental to the program. Now, it's been confirmed that Lucius is not involved in a legal matter. He pleaded guilty in September to misdemeanor reckless driving, also suspended for a game last year for missing class. It's not a legal matter this time around, just violating team rules is the way it's been termed. He's gone for the rest of the year, so it's a thin backcourt for the Spartans as well.
Yes, it is, and you're taking away one of your creators on offense. So it makes Michigan State a little bit more predictable.
Hardaway hits a three. Three-point bucket number 7 in the game. for Michigan, and this is the Wolverines' largest lead up to 11.
And now the Wolverines drop back into a 2-3, it looks like, at the top, but it morphs as the ball swings from side to side.
Appling, a little too strong. Spockers the rebound, outlets to Hardaway. He attacks Kalen Lucas, draws the foul, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Well, Coach Beilein told you, Bob, before the game, if they can take the initial punch from Michigan State, he feels pretty good about his team's chances. Well, they took the first half punch in style with a lead. And everyone knows in basketball the first 5 minutes of the second half are the most important to establish the rest of the game. And Michigan has been very aggressive here to start.
Here comes Draymond Green back in the game. As Derek Nix takes a seat. So Green needed a brief rest to shake off the bump to his left knee. We'll keep our eyes on him, though, and see how easily he's getting up and down the floor. One of two at the line for Hardaway.
15, Horford.
Jordan Morgan back to the bench. John Horford comes back on for Michigan. 6-0 run to open up the second half for the Wolverines and the lead up to 12.
Draymond Green recognizing that this game is slipping from their fingers.
Summers. Long rebound off the three-point miss. Here's Morris, and he'll wait for help.
Wise decision by Darius Morris. Had Smatris trailing, could have taken an open three, but instead churn the Spartans up once again in the half-court set. Make them play defense. Good job by Kalen Lucas right there, staying on Darius Morris's right hand.
Shot clock down to five. Morris with the left hand, lost it in the corner. Shot clock at three, forces it up, gets the roll.
That's by number four, Morris.
Wow. Darius Morris showing you how they do it on the left coast. Los Angeles native showing you some strength in the interior.
Can Michigan build a big enough lead where they can finally get over the hump and stop this trend? 1,181 days it's been since a Wolverine basketball or football team beat a Spartan basketball or football team.
They're doing a really good job here. This zone has slowed the Spartans down.
Shot clock down to five. Summers for three. Got it.
Wow, Zach Novak loses his footing. Can't close out quick enough. And Darrell Summers takes advantage of it. Summers got to be careful.
Novak turns it over. Lucas runs it down and squeezes it up and in. How about that play just to keep it alive and in one motion make the layup?
Well, I think Kalen Lucas is back, ladies and gentlemen. Right there, full speed, stops on the dime and finishes at the bucket. That's a huge play for Michigan State at this juncture.
Timeout called by John Beilein. We'll step aside for just a moment. Is Kalen Lucas back?
Well, Kalen Lucas going full speed, stops on the dime, finishes. I think he's back, folks.
Their team is down, but it's still a party here at the Breslin Center. A 9-point lead for Michigan. The Michigan State fans, though, putting on a show. The Thursday Night Showcase presented by T. Rowe Price, Bob Beschusen, alongside Stephen Bardo, and it has been Michigan in the face of this atmosphere all night, getting it done at the offensive end.
Well, they've taken care of the ball a lot better than Michigan State. They're finding opportunities, and they're getting to their strength, Bob. They lead the Big Ten in threes made per game. So they're attacking the three-point line. They're taking care of the basketball, and they're playing pretty good defense as well.
Shot clock at 10. Stu Douglas with the shot clock down to six. Launches a three. That's off the mark. Ends up with Darrell Summers. The guards have gotten it done for Michigan State. Summers tries to add to it. That's off the mark. Novak the rebound.
For a guy as athletic as Darrell Summers is, Bob, if I'm Michigan State, I'm encouraging him to get to the rim. This is a guy that could be on SportsCenter every night with his leaping ability. But to me, he settles for too many jump shots.
Novak, a three off the loose ball, and he knocks it down.
Zach Novak does not want to end his career without having left his mark here in the Breslin Center. The junior still got another opportunity, but he's seizing the moment right now. Understanding Michigan State, not as confident as they have been in the past. And they've been to overtime already on their home floor twice, once against Northwestern and once against Wisconsin.
Lucas with the crossover. Score the bucket, plus the foul for Caleb Lucas. You know the run is coming at some point. Has Michigan built up enough of a lead to survive? We'll find out. Bob Schuessen and Stephen Bardo back with a look at the strategy session brought to you by T. Rowe Price.
When you're a young team on the road and you shoot the ball from three, as well as any team in the Big Ten, this is what you have to do. You have to get your best shooter open, and that's exactly what Michigan is doing here, getting Zach Novak open looks. Scramble loose ball, hand down, bucket. Zach Novak getting busy from three tonight.
Michigan State is shooting 48% from the field, but they've only got 34 points on the board. These long possessions are shortening the game. You have to think that's going to be a major advantage for Michigan. So many of their buckets are coming late in the shot clock.
They are, and it's been interesting to see that. You think Michigan State, 30 seconds of defense, and they do a stellar job, but that last five, for some reason, they break down. Michigan will make a move into the lane area. The defense will collapse, and they'll kick out for a three. So Michigan, similar in fashion to Notre Dame and how they were able to go to Pitt and shorten the game up. Less possessions. See right here, if they don't get an early look, they'll take a lot of time off the shot clock, let it get inside of 10 seconds, and then try to make a play.
Well, Morris with a wraparound pass. Hardaway sets it back up. Shot clock again goes under 10.
Now he wants to get into the paint and try to create.
Shot clock at four. Morris has to force it up. Just does beat the buzzer, but it's blocked. Great job by Delvon Rowe of staying home. What a defensive year that Delvon Rowe has had. You know, talking to Tom Izzo before the game, he said that Delvon Rowe's been his biggest surprise. He actually came to him a month ago and said, I want to start guarding the best player that the other team's got. I want to be the Big Ten Defensive Player of the Year. How many kids come to you and say that?
Not kids who are as talented as he was coming out of high school.
Hardaway off the turnover. Off to Morris. Takes a bump and still converts.
Michigan really impressive here. Just won't fold. They continue with that double-digit lead, and now they drop back into a zone. See if I can get this word out. That seems to flummox. Did I get that right?
Or flummox, depending on what parish you're from.
Okay, before that shot by Caleb Lucas.
Lucas from the corner makes it an 8-point game.
Now, Bob, just like you said, Michigan State's going to make a run. But the difference is Michigan State is not as deep as they used to be. Only 2 points off the bench tonight.
Morgan called for a foul. Leaned in, and Draymond Green's flop worked. Third foul on Morgan.
Morgan right there doing what a basketball move, but Draymond Green taking a page out of his teammates' book. Delvon Rowe, the thespian, seems to be rubbing off on Draymond Green. Delvon Rowe playing in the role of Shakespeare. Can you imagine that big dude on stage, man? That'd be a sight to see.
Keebler. Flipping over the back of Novak goes Green. And a foul will be called, I believe, on Draymond Green. That's his second.
Park foul 23, Draymond Green, his second foul, and his third.
Well, there you go right there.
You asked for it.
At 6'8", on stage, looking pretty good.
All right, John, thanks very much. It was Stephen Bardo, the Thursday Night Showcase presented by T. Rowe Price. And a surprise, Michigan State just dropping out of the top 25 last week. And they have won 11 consecutive home games against Michigan. The in-state rivalry has been dominated. 18 of the last 21 have gone Michigan State's way, but Michigan has been the better of the two teams tonight.
Well, you see the defense of Michigan State starting to extend.
Backdoor cut. The reverse goes. Beautiful layup by Hardaway off the feet from Novak.
And that's what happens if you try to extend your defense against Michigan. They backdoor you. Hardaway going baseline. Tip your hat to the Wolverines. Their game plan has been flawless to this point.
There's a backdoor cut as well by Lucas. Anything you can do?
I can do it just as well. That's a set play for Michigan State. Trying to get a bucket at the hole.
Kalen Lucas has scored the last 10 for Michigan State.
Lucas and Summers, 33 of the 40 Spartan points, so they are doing their fair share. Trying to make up for the loss of Corey Lucius.
Tipped ball, falls to no man's land. Kalen Lucas has it. You know the run's coming. You wonder when. Here's Green. Down low to Rowe. Forces it up. No good. Crowd looking for a foul call.
And if you want to know how strong Zach Novak is, take a look at that last play.
Green rips it out of the arms of Darius Morris.
Now that's Michigan State basketball that we've grown accustomed to.
Lucas can't hit the three, though. And the back tap ends up with Stu Douglas. And he'll wait for some help. Morris tried to attack and turned it over again. Draymond Green the other way. Plus the foul.
Michigan getting sloppy with the rock. Draymond Green, knowing that his team needs a play, and he has been making it. Hardaway Jr. going backdoor as Michigan State starting to increase the presence. And then sweet bounce pass on the back door for Kalen Lucas. Set play from Tom Izzo.
Green, unlocked this one.
The horn sounded at the scorer's table inadvertently, so they get that cleared up. Draymond Green will try and cut what once was a 41-27 lead, so a 14-point lead for Michigan. Tried to get it to five. It stays instead at six. Although it's run out in the corner off of Jordan Morgan.
And look at Novak getting in Morgan's face. Once again, telling him, look, young fella, I know this is your first trip up here, but I know what it takes. You got to come up with those loose balls. Good job of the Spartans. Kicking the intensity level up, getting back into this game. Martin's going really small. Keeber, Thornton, Lucas, and Appling all in the game.
And then Lucas turns it over. Hardaway swoops in, draws the foul. ESPN's the home court of College Hoops. Saturday afternoon, catch two games on ESPN. First of all, in the Big East at noon, Villanova, Georgetown. And then at 4 Eastern, we go to the SEC as Kentucky looks to bounce back from a loss to Georgia earlier this year. Both games available online at ESPN3.com and on your phone. College basketball presented by 5-Hour Energy coming up this Saturday on ESPN.
Old Georgetown starting out in the Big East. Struggling mightily, now starting to turn around with this smackdown of St. John's in their last game. And what happened to Villanova? Providence. Put it on them like they stole something.
What happened to Syracuse? Seton Hall put it on them. There are surprising results often in that league.
And I would have never thought that Syracuse would drop three straight in the Big East, as tough as that conference is. But the Orange looks so good in the pre-conference schedule.
How about some other NCAA news and notes? Jimmer Fredette continues to put on a show, and did he put on one last night? There's the upset of Providence against Villanova, and Texas still unbeaten in the Big 12.
Yeah, Jimmer Fredette. I tell you what, I have to get a Jimmer Fredette T-shirt or something. This dude here, hip-hop star from, or hip-hop enthusiast, I should say, because his brother's the star. Hip-hop guy that's out at BYU putting daggers in. I mean, people are draping all over him, and he's hitting daggers all over the floor.
Darius Morris just called for his second personal foul, a hand check out on the edge. Green sets up Thornton. He bobbled it and turned it over. Shuffled his feet trying to reset after bobbling what was a perfect pass from Green.
Hey, Austin Thornton not playing with a lot of confidence right now. You can tell on his release that it's not fluid. He's thinking too much and he's struggling. You cannot think when you're shooting the rock. Morris wants the high screen and roll so he can get right.
Throws it right through the hands of Jordan Morgan. That's a sophomore and a redshirt freshman trying to execute on the road. Six turnovers this half for Michigan.
And Michigan goes back to a man-to-man defense. Zach Novak guarding Draymond Green. I know how strong Zach is, but I'd look for that matchup right there.
A foul called on Draymond Green on the push-off as he tried to wall off Novak.
Well, we expected Michigan State to go to this matchup. And Draymond Green got to be careful, though. Critical situation. You don't want to pick up a technical foul in that situation.
Three straight turnovers for Michigan State. That's the third foul on Draymond Green. Fifth team foul on Michigan State.
Well, look who is guarding Zach Novak, the player that went to Izzo and said, I want to guard the opposing team's best player. Well, there you go.
Morris weaves his way inside and scores. Pretty move by Darius Morris.
Ooh, Darius Morris got away with a little hook, too. Sophomore showing veteran skill set here.
16 for Morris to go along with five rebounds. He and Zach Novak both with 16 points. So they've been the offensive stars tonight for Michigan. Bob Wischusen and Stephen Bardo bringing you the Thursday Night Showcase presented by T. Rowe Price. You wonder if Michigan has built up enough of kind of a cachet here that when the run comes, as it slowly seems to have, that they'll be able to hold off Michigan State.
Well, I think, Bob, with the way that they play, they're shortening the game with taking a lot of time in their possessions. And so if they continue to stay with that theme and try to get late into the shot clock and create something, as long as they can find Novak and Darius Morris, I think they'll be just fine. I think we could actually see an upset here tonight, the way Michigan is shooting the basketball and taking care of the rock.
Well, the other thing Michigan has done is they've limited the front court scoring for the most part for Michigan State. Delbon Rowe and Draymond Green haven't been huge factors tonight. For the most part, it's been Kalen Lucas and Darrell Summers. They've got 33 of the 42 for the Spartans.
Yeah, and we talked earlier that the Michigan State Spartans of the past have been so deep, and they've had so many different players, and yet now their depth is even less with Corey Lucas being out, and they've been a two-man gang here tonight.
Another miss by Darrell Summers.
And see what happens. Michigan State's looking up at the clock. They're inside 8 minutes, and now they got to play defense for 30 seconds.
Hardaway throws up a wild one, but he will shoot free throws when we come back, and he can put the lead back to double figures for Michigan. All right, John, thanks very much. Here in East Lansing, it's a 9-point advantage for Michigan, and Michigan State now has to deal with the four fouls of Draymond Green.
Well, Draymond Green, they're trying to get him going. He's really struggled tonight. You see the push-off right there. If you do that in front of the official, they're going to do that every time. And when you have three fouls and a guy is being guarded closely by Summers, not a wise choice by Green right there to put his team and himself in jeopardy with his fourth foul.
You can see Tim Hardaway Jr. saying, whoa, where's the technical, as he saw Draymond Green's reaction to foul number three. Antonio Petty gave him a lot of leeway to have his say and react, but Green with only 4 points. He and Delvon Rowe have, for the most part, been a non-factor. It's been all Kalen Lucas and Darrell Summers trying to carry Michigan State.
And see, when Corey Lucius is gone now, these two, Draymond Green, Delvon Rowe, they average 20 points between them. They only have 5 points tonight. So puts a lot of pressure on Lucas and Summers to try to carry this ball club.
One of two at the line for Hardaway, makes it a 10-point lead once again. Green sets up Kalen Lucas. And Novak ends up with the loose ball.
Well, once again, an open look.
Wide open look and a quick shot taken by Douglas. But an offensive rebound. Novak tries a three. He's got another. The sixth three of the game for Zach Novak. He's got 19.
When you shoot three-point shots, they're going to be long rebounds. So you have to extend your box out.
An answer, though, from Draymond Green.
Well, this has been a theme a lot this year. When Michigan State gets down, Draymond Green really forces the issue. And he's definitely going to have to do that tonight. Summers, since he got in foul trouble, he really hasn't been a factor in the second half. Rowe hasn't either. Rowe's had three attempts, 0 for 3 thus far.
Hardaway spins, and Summers rebounds.
If Michigan State's going to get back in this game, Bob, they need some easy buckets. They had a set play to get Lucas an open shot. But besides that, they have really not attacked the rim.
And now the patience of a very young Michigan team. Look at Morris walking up the floor, shorten the game, take it under 6 minutes with a 10-point lead.
I do like one of our old colleagues used to do. It's like a boa constrictor.
Hardaway rejected by Summers. Here comes Appling. Finds Lucas. And Kalen Lucas will go to the free throw line as Darius Morris is called for the foul. That's his third.
Nice aggressiveness by Michigan State. We talked about them needing to get an open look, an easy bucket. They forced the issue that time and got a two-on-one look.
Kalen Lucas already over 20 points for the fourth time this season. Last year with the torn Achilles in the second round of the NCAA tournament, it took him 6 months to rehab an injury that will oftentimes take guys a year. And a lot of players will say that it's a good year and a half to 2 years after a torn Achilles before they really feel like themselves again. Well, he's back up to 14 points and about 4 assists a game. And Tom Izzo said that he saw it coming, that he feels as if he is turning the corner. And he's starting to look like Kalen Lucas again.
Well, it's an amazing statistic or fact when you think about basketball players are rhythm guys. So in the summer, they work on different parts of their game. Well, he had no time to work on his game this summer. He was just rehabbing. So for him to be playing at this level right now, playing through the season and getting his quickness back, that's quite a feat by the senior.
Foul called on Delvon Rowe, bumping Horford out near midcourt. That'll be team foul number 7 on Michigan State. So that will put John Horford at the free throw line. And the mental part of the game, apparently not a strong point right now for Michigan State, according to their head coach.
Well, I like what he's doing because you don't mind their aggressiveness. They're trying to turn up the heat defensively. But typically, you've got to stay one arm length away when you're defending.
Well, you could read the lips of Tom Izzo. He's saying, guys, there's no need. Why are you trying to guard John Horford, who averages 2.5 points a game, a freshman, 28 feet from the basket, when he's not going to shoot it unless he's 8 feet from the basket?
Right. And it just puts them in further foul trouble, which limits what they can do later on in this game.
hustles it up. No good. Horford the rebound. Draymond Green continues to play with four fouls.
Tip your hat off once again to Zach Novak. Doesn't get a lot of credit defensively. Each game gives up several inches on the post, but holds his ground and forces Green to make the shot without foul.
Once again, Michigan takes the shot clock under 10. Morris lost it. Appling for three. He's got it. That's a 5-point game.
We've seen this before. Keith Appling scored a season high 19 against Northwestern.
Timeout, Michigan. They all knew the run was coming. Can Michigan take another punch from Michigan State and hold them off? There's at least three or four times in this game where the Wolverines have taken that body blow and had answers. Will they have answers the last 4.5 minutes?
Well, we'll see right here. This is the closest Michigan State has been here in the second half. So let's see if Darius Morris can handle the pressure that Michigan State is applying.
Douglas, tough fadeaway. He's got it. Stu Douglas with a terrific fadeaway jumper.
He popped Kalen Lucas in the chest to get free. Then he spun and shot off his baby pinky toe. Nothing but cotton. Stu Douglas, that was a huge bucket. Kalen Lucas has got to be the man to create.
Tries to do just that with a nice pump fake, but can't hit the bunny. Hardaway the rebound. 3.5 minutes to go.
Kalen Lucas has had a point-blank look. Draymond Green missed a point-blank look. Michigan State resembles a younger team at this point.
Knocked out of bounds by Appling. Punch, counterpunch for the Wolverines.
Stu Douglas. It's pretty. Spin, baby toe, fade, cotton. And Tom Izzo trying to figure out a way to get his Spartans on track.
Well, Sal, Sean White's numbers impressive. Those numbers are impressive as well. 1,181 days. Since a Wolverine football team or basketball team beat a Spartan football team or basketball team. But the ticket's not quality that they pass out in Ann Arbor, but they take them all as that little gold section is trying to witness the breaking of a long drought for the Wolverines against the Spartan team. Can Michigan hang on in the last 3 minutes and get this win at Michigan State?
Under 10 once again on the shot clock.
Down to 5. Does Douglas realize it? He doesn't. Hardaway launches. In and out. But it's bobbled out of bounds by Draymond Green, and it goes right back over with a fresh 35 to Michigan.
Well, Michigan, you create your breaks on the road. And there's an unwritten rule that to win a game on the road, you have to be 10 points better than your opponent.
Tom Izzo thought that it might have been a shot clock violation. I think he thinks that Hardaway didn't get the ball off before the shot clock went to zeros.
It was close.
Let's take another look and see. It looks like he got that off in time.
Definitely got it off. A surprise, though, Douglas giving it up to the freshman at that point. Douglas, the upperclassman, you'd think he's going to create something.
See Darius Marks there? He just came and took the ball from Jordan Morgan. I don't even think Morgan realized he was there. And now Morgan gets fouled. Saturday night, ESPN and ESPNU team up to give you two great Big 12 college basketball matchups. First at 7 Eastern on ESPN, Kansas welcomes arch rival Kansas State to the Fog. And then at 9 Eastern, how about this matchup on ESPNU? Number 13 at number 8, Missouri and Texas. ESPN, the home court of college hoops on ESPN and ESPNU. It's Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV.
This is toughness right here if Michigan can hit their free throws.
And Morgan can't hit the front end. That was team foul number 8 on the Spartans. Michigan still has one foul to give. And they've got the possession arrow. Lucas fades away. He went one-on-one and got it done.
That's bitter beer face right there. Stutter step, step back, fade away.
Did you say bitter beer face? Tom Izzo called the timeout and had a chat with Pat Driscoll. He's been that frustrated probably tonight watching Zach Novak do this work.
Yeah, Zach Novak came to play this evening. On the road against your in-state rival. Haven't had much success against the Spartans, but it's not because of Zach Novak's effort and grit. We're seeing his threes, but he's played very good defense on the in the interior, and he's urged his teammates to go after loose balls.
137 career threes now for Zach Novak. Already well into the top 10 in Michigan history, shooting the three. And he might need one or two more of those in the last 2.5 minutes if Michigan's going to hold off Michigan State.
Yeah, they definitely, they're going to have to be around the 63 to 65 point mark right here.
This was the intensity we saw from Novak in the first half when we went to a break.
And you got to have that if you're going to win. A lot of times players will tune their coaches out. But if you've got an upperclassman getting in your face, you have to respect that.
Morris works his way inside, blocked by Applin. The loose ball ends up being corralled by Darrell Summers. A chance for Michigan State to make it a one-possession game.
Darius Morris is getting too deep into that paint area, trying to force the issue. Good defense by the Spartans. Trying to lock it down here.
Kalen Lucas hangs and hits, plus the foul.
Kalen Lucas got pushed in the back right there. Took the push on the back, hit from the front. Jackknife, degree of difficulty 9.8 off the glass. Kalen Lucas trying to carry his team home.
That was the third foul on Novak. 27 for Kalen Lucas, and it's a two-point game.
I think he wants to be the senior that allowed Michigan to win. In the Breslin Center? I don't think so. Morris has got to trust his offense.
Timeout called by John Beilein with the shot clock at 13. And the Michigan bench looking for a foul, saying that Darius Morris got his jersey tugged in the lane.
Bob, I'm sorry. This is the Big Ten. This is what happens when you go on the road. I don't care if it's the Breslin Center, Assembly Hall, or at Ohio State. You got to be tough if you're going to beat a team like Michigan State on their home floor. You can't cry to the officials. You got to do it on your own.
Now, Michigan State started off the season thinking we're a top five team, might go to the Final Four. They are 4-3 now in the Big Ten. They've got this game against Michigan, a 1-6 team in conference. Their next two against Indiana and Iowa, before you look at the run they have, Wisconsin, Ohio State still to come. If they want a challenge for the Big Ten title, not only is this a must-win, the next two are must-wins as well. You can't lose at home to Michigan if you want to hold on to hopes that you're going to win the conference.
You're exactly right, Bob. You can't lose any time on your home court and win a Big Ten title. And so they've had two overtime challenges, and they've come out on top. Let's see if Michigan can hold on.
After the timeout, shot clock at 10. Morris with the shot clock down to 5. Morris with a crossover. Shot clock at 2. Douglas can't get it off. It hits the front of the rim. They say he did get it off in time. No harm done for Michigan State, though. Summers corrals the rebound. 11 minutes to go in the first half, the last time that Michigan State had the lead. Here's Appling for the lead. In and out. Morgan the rebound.
Good look by Appling. I mean, you can't get a much better look than that if you're Michigan State. And if I'm Michigan right here, I got to get Zach Novak the rock on the three-point line.
Timeout now called by John Beilein with 14 on the shot clock. The last timeout for Michigan. Maybe our final timeout as we go back to John Saunders.
Bob, just want to update a couple of things for you. Duke now starting to pull away from Boston College, a 9-point lead, 41-32. Singler has 9 points, as you can see there. Vanderbilt over Mississippi State with about 2 minutes left in that one, just a 5-point lead. And when that one is done over on ESPN2, Tyler Honeycutt and UCLA in action against Arizona as part of a triple header over on ESPN2. Bob, back to you.
All right, thanks a lot, John. Well, it was a 13-point lead for Michigan with 7:05 to play. This is the 13-2 run that we figured was coming from Michigan State at some point, making it a 2-point game with 33 seconds to go. Bob Schusel, Stephen Bardo here at the Breslin Center. Neither team with a foul to give. Michigan with 16 fouls and Michigan State with 8. No timeouts left for Michigan, but they do have the arrow.
They do have the arrow, and they have possession here, so you expect a set play. They've tried to run Darius Morris off of a high screen and roll, get him going right when he's so dangerous. But Michigan State has adjusted defensively. Don't be surprised if you see a miss by Michigan, that Michigan State will try to run it up without a timeout and score rather quickly.
And strategically, the way Michigan has played the game, taking the shot clock down inside of 10 seconds, has gotten them to this point, right?
It has. It's shortened the game up. Less possessions, lower scoring, gives them an opportunity to win.
14 on the shot clock for the Wolverines.
Keith Appling, outstanding on-the-ball defender.
5 on the shot clock for Morris. Trying to create some space. It's Douglas. Got a 3! Stu Douglas hits the triple with 20 seconds to go.
Michigan State's got to rush it up here. Got to look for a 3 at this point.
Lucas bobbled the ball. And then a timeout called by Tom Izzo. He still has 2 left, so 1 remaining now. How about the shot by Stu Douglas with the shot clock winded down?
This is what Michigan does. They get to the paint. We've seen it all game. They penetrate to the paint area. The defense naturally sinks in. It's not natural for you defensively to stay out on shooters. You try to help the penetration. Draymond Green off just a little bit. Stu Douglas knocks it down.
10 threes tonight for Michigan. They're 10 of 21 from behind the arc, shooting 47% from three-point land for a team that came into tonight averaging 33%, 10th best or 9th best in the Big Ten.
Well, that's all confidence. And right now, Michigan playing with supreme confidence. They impose their will here in the Breslin Center.
Now, the other thing to keep in mind is Michigan tonight has struggled from the free throw line. They are 4 of 10 from the free throw line. So if you can get the quick hitter and foul, you might still have a chance.
Oh, they definitely still have a chance. It's got to be quick here, though. Summers on the 3.
Draymond Green leans in for a 3. In and out. The back tap, though. Lucas tries a triple. That deadens. Summers has it. Appling for three with 5 seconds to go. That's in and out. The putback inside by Green. And a quick timeout called. But so much time is off the clock. Does Michigan State still have a chance with 2.7 seconds to go?
And Summers comes up with the offensive rebound. You still need 5 points. Get the quick deuce. Turn around and try to foul. But it took a lost a lot of valuable time there.
What an effort by Michigan. Executing the game plan set out by John Beilein. They take the early punch. They have shortened the game, kept it low scoring. Now, if you're Michigan State, you're Tom Izzo. What are you trying to draw up in the huddle with 2.7 seconds to go? Winner X Games 15 is standing by. And what's your hope?
Well, if you throw the ball long like a receiver and you throw it back to this end of the court where Michigan is, it takes Michigan State, even if they steal the rock, it takes them another 2 seconds to get it back in the scoring position. So don't be surprised to see some misdirection up front and someone flying back for a long pass and see if Michigan can get the ball in without being fouled.
So you're saying you play the percentages if you're John Beilein, even if you have it stolen in the backcourt with only 2.7 seconds remaining, there's probably not enough time for them to even get a quality look.
They've got to steal the ball and get back on this end of the floor and still try to come up with a three. So, just a stunned crowd here.
Well, it turns out that the drive in the snow is worth it for that group. They got lousy tickets, but they've seen a great game.
Yes, they have. They've been rewarded for their support.
Not hard to tell from that picture who's winning. One guy's distressed, the other guy's texting his buddy saying, we got this. 2.7 seconds to go. It's inbounded to Morris. The foul given with 1 second remaining.
Michigan State foul, 23, Green.
Draymond Green fouls out.
Well, you talk about a team that was desperate for a win. Michigan lost six in a row. Coming here, hold a team that usually scores 72 points a game to 57 points on their home court. Team that's reeling with the loss of Corey Lucius. See if Morris can ice.
And he's got the front end, and that will do it. Now it's a four-point game, and now that Michigan bench mathematically can celebrate. They know they've got it locked up. Appling lets it go. And Michigan, for the first time in nearly 1,200 days, beats Michigan State in either basketball or football. What a terrific effort by the Wolverines on the road here at Michigan State. The final score, Michigan wins it, 61-57. For Stephen Bardo and our entire crew, I'm Bob Wischusen. Winner X Games 15 coming up next. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Let's go out to Aspen, Colorado.